atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around. But the Spirit of the Lord is here. Atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around. The Spirit of the Lord is here. With your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love surrounds us. Overflow in this place, fill our hearts with Song, lift your voice as heaven and earth give praise. And fall to your knees at the feet, the Son of the one true God. Come and turn from old ways, lift your eyes, for the kingdom of God is here. And open your heart, offer all for Jesus Christ. Is he now? We have found our hope, we have found our peace, we have found our
Love endures. Almighty, your love endures, you are merciful, and you are worthy of all the praise and worship that we give to you today. And we ask, God, that you keep the incense of our hearts burning to heaven, God, that we may give you the praise and the worship and the adoration that you deserve. God, we declare you are greater than what we can imagine. You are greater than the heavens, God. You are above all things. And we exalt you today. We bless your name with all that we have. And we come before you as your children. We thank you, Father. We pray these things in Jesus' name. We will now be going into a time of worship in the Word. So I invite you to open up your Bibles to Psalm chapter 91. And we'll go through verses 1 through 16. Verses 1 through 16. Psalm 91, 1 through 4. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. God, we declare this morning that you are our shelter and our refuge. If there is anyone or anything to which we go or for comfort, would you reveal it to us so that we may turn back to you? We ask that you give us strength to resist temptations that lure us into finding rest and peace in worldly things. These things may give us temporary rest and pleasure, but you are the only one who truly knows us, truly accepts us, and truly loves us.
In my time of need, shall I feel, oh, when you're my shall I fear? Oh, when you're
the Lord God Almighty. This is
Destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. We thank you, Jesus, for overcoming all evil and for giving us the authority to overcome evil and every fear in your name. There is nothing that is above you and nothing that is more powerful than your name. And to this name we were called to know and live by. Even in the midst of fear and evil, you have fully equipped us to fight and be conquerors. We may be overwhelmed at times, but we ask you to reveal to us how much greater you are than our circumstances.
Casting away the darkness in the dead of night.
destruction all around. I look to you, I look to you, I look to you. When I see your face, I see only you.
Fix my eyes on you. Fix my eyes on you. Amidst all the terror.
God, that you give us the strength and the boldness and the wisdom, Father, to conquer all our enemies and to conquer evil and to glorify your name. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
And you
to the one who has welcomed me home, to the Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge, no evil shall be allowed to befall you, no plague come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against the stone. He will tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Lord, the greatest commandment you have given to us is to love you with all our heart, soul, strength, and mind. By doing this, we make you our dwelling place, our refuge, and our shelter. You are the only one we can go to just as we are and have no fear or doubts. And you promise us victory and strength as a result of us coming to you. God, we want to taste and experience how good your presence is. We want to see how beautiful you are and know that nothing else compares.
For your hand is upon me, and your grace is upon me. Place, I have made you my refuge. God, you are my refuge. No evil shall befall me. The plague come against me. Shelter. Oh, here in the shadow, here in my refuge,
there's no need to leave. I abide in you. Take refuge, make my home in your verses 13 through 16. Because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Father, you are the one who loves to hear your people. You are one who burns with love for your children. You hear every cry and see every tear. You know every pain that we feel, and you know exactly where we are. And when we cry to you, you do not miss a beat to come to us, to deliver us, to protect us, to answer us, and to rescue us. We ask that you remind us this morning that you are our good Father who showers us with your unconditional love.
absence of wrong, my sin washed away in your blood. Too much to make sense of it all. I know that your love breaks my fall. The scandal of grace, you died in my place, oh my soul. To be like you, give all I have just to know you, Jesus. There's no one beside you, forever the hope in my heart. So grace, grace, what have you done? You murdered for me. Sin washed away in your blood. Too much to make sense of it all. I know that your love breaks my fall. The scandal of grace, you died in my place, so my soul will live. Oh, to be like you. Give all I have just to know you, Jesus. There's no one beside you, forever the hope in my heart. Oh, to be like you. Give all I have just to know you, Jesus. There's no one beside you. Forever the hope in my heart. And death, where is your sting? Your power is as dead as my sin. Cross has taught me to live. Mercy my heart now to sing. The day its troubles shall come. I know that your strength is enough. The scandal of grace, you died in my place, so my soul will live. Oh, to be like you. Give all I have just to know you, Jesus. There's no one beside you, forever the hope in my heart. Oh, to be like you. Give all I have just to know you, Jesus. There's no one beside you, forever the hope in my heart. Jesus, it's all because of your love that my soul will live. And it's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of your love that my soul will live. To be like you, give all I have just to know you, Jesus. There's no one beside you, forever the hope in my heart. Oh, to be like you, give all I have just to know. Jesus, there's no one beside you, forever the hope in my heart.
you, Father, that there is no one beside you, and that we are comforted in your presence, and we are at peace and at rest in your grace. We thank you, Father. We pray these things in Jesus' name. We'll now transition into a time of intercession. Today we'll be lifting up the Korean diaspora who are returning to Korea to live. I invite you to follow with your own prayers after my prayers. Father, we thank you for the Korean diaspora who are returning to Korea at this time. We believe that you are leading them back to Korea for a reason, and that they are part of your plans for this nation. We ask that you would give them a greater heart of compassion, that they will desire to invest in and contribute to the society instead of personal gain and accomplishments. For those who have been living here, we ask that you renew their hearts and give them fresh compassion that will lead them to help those in need. Let's pray. God, there are more and more Korean diaspora returning to this nation. And so we ask for more open doors for them to work in different industries and businesses in Korea. We pray that more companies employ the Korean diaspora who will be able to bring about a change to the current culture that can be detrimental to growth and love. We also pray for open doors for the Korean diaspora to meet and connect with people of authority, and also to be able to work in companies of great influence. God, would you lead more and more diaspora walking in integrity and righteousness to this nation? Let's pray. Father, you know very well the struggles of the Korean diaspora community living in Korea. Whether they chose to come back or whether they had no choice, it is difficult to live in a culture with which they are not familiar. Through this, bitterness and a heart of unforgiveness could grow, but we ask you, Holy Spirit, to help them extend grace and forgive the natives. We come against every wall of division because unity is what you desire for us. We prophesy love, like-mindedness, creativity, innovation, and revival to arise through the unity between the Korean diaspora and the natives and the locals. Let's pray. We ask earnestly that the Korean diaspora would be marked with love for their motherland and its people. We ask you, Holy Spirit, to give them the ability to love their neighbors and help the vulnerable groups of the society. We also ask that love abounds within the diaspora community, that there is no jealousy, no hatred, no comparison, no quarreling, and no division. And through this heart of love, we pray that the Korean diaspora community abhors what is evil, is patient, is kind, is merciful, is selfless, and values justice. Let's pray. God, we thank you for the Korean diaspora community in this nation, and we thank you that you have called specific people to return at this hour. And Father, we pray that their hearts would abound with compassion. Father, that you open doors for them to work and to be of great influence. Father, that you would bind us together in unity, and that we would manifest the love of the Father to this nation and to one another. Father, we pray blessings upon the community. God, I pray that they will not be in a place of pride and condescension, but God, that they would be in a place of compassion and have the desire to help those around them. And Father, we pray grace upon them, that you would protect them and that you would lead them and guide them to where you have plans for them. We thank you, Father, and we pray these things in your name. Amen.
And I cast my mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down. Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone, Messiah still and all alone. And oh, praise the
shall return in robes of white, Never failed us. You're a God who promises to keep us and preserve us until the day that we meet you face to face. Through all the trials, through all the persecution, through all the hardships, we know that we can trust in you. You're a God who will finish everything that you've begun in us, and you'll accomplish everything that you've set out to do. We thank you, Father, for your word, for your promise that keeps us and carries us through. We thank you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name.